under the British and the Nizam. So how the British and the Nizam, what are the permanent settlements, what are the different changes happened, how the Jamindaris and peasants and Nizams were exploiting the peasants, these are all we discussed in the previous class. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the Raitwari system. What is the Raitwari system? Rait means cultivator. Well, Raitwari means peasants tenure. Peasants tenure. So, how to give peasants tenure? It was decided to collect revenue from the peasants. The government, here the company decided, company means British people. When the company was decided to give land, whoever people are working, whoever cultivating the lands, and who are the owners of the land, and cultivators of the land, they are simply giving a fixed rent. See here, the peasants cultivating the land were identified. First they were identified it, and their field was identified, and they have given a number to that, and every piece of land fixing the legal ownership. They have given a legal ownership. That means a patta. In the keywords I explained, legal ownership was that. Legal ownership they have given, and a survey number was given to every piece of land and fixed a legal ownership. And they gave, for example, a 5 acres land is there. So they will see how the yield and prices, price situation, market price, market conditions, and what are the crops cultivation depends on all those things. They are making a fixed revenue, fixed tax. They are levying a fixed tax. That is called Raitwari system. So in that, Munro, but before that, before the tenure commencing, before telling that, Munro, Thomas Munro, there was a collector came, Thomas Munro. This Thomas Munro from England, he decided to give a few money to, before cultivating, money to people. For what? For peasants. For what? For giving, for buying seeds and for buying fertilizers. Okay. And for repair charges, anything, or for digging new wells and all. For that he has given a money, and he cooperated with them. And after that, if a good collection is there, then they will collect the revenue. That is the first thing. Because if right is good, then only they will get yield, good yield. If right is not prosperous, they cannot do that. That's why Munro made necessary advances. Advance he has given to the peasant for what? For buying bullocks, for seeds, or for repairing some instruments, agricultural instruments, or digging new wells and all. And this proved, after that, if we gave everything to the farmer, definitely farmer is a very hard worker and can do the things. And that year, it was a bumper crop, bumper yield they got, and very good revenue collection. If it is a good money, it was more productive they got, definitely they'll pay the revenue, isn't it? So like that, it was proved, Munro's system was proved that it was very effective, and on that particular year, there is a very good crop, and even revenues are also paid by the peasants. So everybody said that, yes, Munro's approach was very correct, Thomas Munro's approach was very correct. Then, see the year, and some more developmental activities they have done in the country still continue to depending upon the rainfall. The expectation of the Jamindaris and prosperous rites would invest in a smaller irrigational, that I will tell you afterwards. First to see this. Under Raitwari system, I produced more crop. And company thinks that company collects fixed tax from farmers. They will be collecting good tax. And Jamindaris rented land and to the tenants. Jamindaris also giving a big land to the tenants. So after that, there were some developmental activities were started in Prakasham Barrage, that's it.
See them. Some British administrators believed that it is a duty of the government, to invest a large scale irrigational works. This would enable farmers, that will be useful for farmers to cultivate lands and grow high yield of varieties, a variety of value cash crops they will get. And one more thing is, due to the untiring efforts of Sir Arthur Cotton. Sir Arthur Cotton is one of the Viceroy General. He came and he cut across the Godavari River. Here, Godavari River, he made a dam. Near the Dhavaleshwaram was completed in 1849. It brought immediate changes, immediate prosperity to the district, which had suffered acutely from severe famine. There were severe famine was started in from 1833. The farmers were suffering since 1833. Similarly, an aqueduct was built over the Krishna River also. Krishna River also at Vijayawada in 1854, which brought prosperity in the delta areas. After 1857, the Kurnool, the Kadapa Canal was built to bring waters to the drier areas at Rayalaseema, even Rayalaseema also. So in Rayalaseema in Andhra Pradesh, they made a few developmental activities. These measures, even though they are significant, a very limited impact they cover. But Sir Arthur Cotton he made good proposal, Sir Arthur Cotton, and he started a lot of developmental activities. He made a bridge on built a bridge on Dhavaleshwaram near Rajahmundry, and also in the Krishna River in Vijayawada. So because of this, many lands were cultivated, because a lot of rainfall, they can store the water in the reservoirs and they can use that water to the irrigational purposes. Even though it is a very least thing what they have done, because it is a limited impact, very limited impact. It means that very few peasants were benefited in that areas. But it's a very limited effort. Why? Because the other areas were not developed. These are developmental activities, means everywhere in country they have to do it. So, but they did not do that. It's a limited areas only in some areas in Andhra and Telangana, Andhra and Rayalaseema they made it. And even Jamindaris also, they were not encouraging the peasants by giving seeds and all. What they thought is, if Munro started his approach like this, even some other Jamindars will do like that. But the Jamindars did not done like that. And what they have done is, only they are collecting the revenue and they are giving a rent, they are giving their lands to the peasants, and they are collecting the taxes. So their main intention is only collecting taxes, not about the lands and the peasants. They are not developing lands and peasants. So even Sir Arthur Cotton made such a big effort also, it is limited only. Why? Because the commercialization. Because of what was the result of that? After developmental activities, what was the result? Even in Raithwari areas, the land revenue was fixed at very high level. Unlike the Jamindari areas, it was fixed for 20 to 30 years. After that, the expiry of 10-year period, the revenue was revised, taking the change in conditions into consideration. The land revenue was so high at the beginning, and it had to be collected by force. So whenever the they are increasing the tax system. So when the tax is increasing every year, but these peasants' lives are like that only, and every year they have to invest something. Once if the crop failure or once the famines, they face famines, at that time they are unable to cook up for the next year. And they are unable to pay the tax also. So such a time, that is a very big burden to only for the farmers, not for the jamindaris or not for the company, that is British. So this was the final result. Why? Because here the one thing,
was 2-7 times more than the land revenue paid right to the government. So right is how much he is paying to the government or whatever he is getting benefit. On that, most of them 3-7 times more than that they are paying to the jamindars. So that is not a benefit. That is a very much problem facing by the peasants. And as a result, they were not interested to the improving agriculture, but only renting it for the higher and higher rates. So, for example, jamindar is giving a land to the peasant. Then what happens? The peasant, if these cultivators is unable to pay that rent, then immediately they are taking land from them and they are giving to another farmer, another cultivator. Like that, they are changing. Because of all these things, there is no improvement in the agriculture, and they are not getting more produce. And at the same day, often hitting of famines and all, no rainfalls, and high rates of interest and all, what with the money lenders, the peasants were facing a lot of problems. So this was the result after making the development activities and even the right policy system was implemented. Okay, and next, the commercialization and money lenders. The fourth one is, apart from all these things, commercialization and money lenders. Who are the money lenders? I told you, money lenders are informal organizations. For example, if you want some money, if you go through the bank and or some other recognized institute, then for everyone the same interest rate and all. So it will be uniform for everyone, isn't it? But these informal organizations like money lenders and pan brokers, these are all, what they will do, they will keep a lot of interest, different types of interest they will be levying on the principal amount. And once they take principal amount, the interest will be more and more than the double and triple sometimes from the principal amount. So principal amount they are taking, for example, they are taking 5,000. But all together they keep all, levy all the interest and all. Finally, it may be, the interest may be 20,000 or 25,000. Then what happens, total they have to be 25,000. If they pick 5,000, this will be the problem. For total 25,000 they have to pay. So the farmers were failed to pay all those things. And more commercialization happened, driven by the desire to increase the income from land. Revenue officials fixed a very high revenue demand. And sometimes our company people are asking more and more revenue. And peasants were unable to pay these revenue and fled the countryside. And they are leaving their lands and they are simply going to some other classes or some other areas. And as villages became deserted in many regions, because of that, many regions, the villages were becoming empty, isn't it? And optimist officials had imagined that the new system would transform the peasants into rich entrepreneurial farmers. But this did not happen due to very high end land revenue and people are borrowing monies and all. This is all because of the commercialization and money lenders. Money lenders are exploiting on one side, jamindaris are exploiting on the other side, and company people, that is British people, are insisting to pay the taxes. So these are all with the people, farmers are fed up with these activities. So we discuss about the remaining topics in the next class session. Children, thank you.